the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, now to prepare ourselves to celebrate these two encouraging mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess
to my God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
My wrath will flare up, and I will kill you with a sword, then your own wives will be widows and your children orphans. If you lend money to one of your poor neighbors among my people, you shall not act like an extortioner toward him by demanding interest from him. If you take your neighbor's cloak as a pledge, you shall return it to him before sunset, for this cloak of his is the only covering he has for his body. What else has he to sleep in? If he cries out to me, I will hear him, for I am compassionate. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together at one of them, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested Jesus by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the final first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself." The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments. The Gospel of the Lord.